Hello guys, new Zen UV 4.4 here. Improved Quadrify, favorites, and much more. Let's go! Zen UV has a lot of different operators and tools that are located in different panels, and we decided to make favorites to collect frequently used operators in one place. To add operator to favorites, you need to right-click on any button, select the button, add to favorites, click OK, and see that the button appears at the top. Let's add another button, for example, checker. Now these two operators are in quick access. If we move to preferences, we will see that we can use favorites on top of all panels, as a separate panel, and also as a floating one. We can save our buttons as preset. Then add another preset. At the top, we can quickly switch between different presets. You can also add not only buttons, but also entire panels and even properties. What's important is that all these can be added not only from Zen UV, you can add buttons, panels and properties from anywhere, be it native Blender functionality or third-party add-on operators. To show all the capabilities of this system, we have added ready-made presets, in which you can find examples of organizing parameters. You can also add an external script, a text block, or select an operator from the search list, for example, Mark Sims by Sharp. Keep in mind that the favorites presets for 3D view and UV contexts are separate. Favorites will also appear in the pop-up menu, giving you quick access to operators anywhere. We have added such a useful tool as Split to more effectively separate UVs. To do this, select edges where you want to make the cut and click Split. In the parameters, we have a checkbox for minimum distance or adjustable. We also added Merge. If the native Merge by distance merges any vertices, Merge in Zen UV merges only those vertices on UV that have common vertices on the geometry. Very useful, isn't it? You can also pin vertices that will not move during merge. To do this, activate Use Pinned checkbox and increase merge distance. We have improved Quadrify operator. Now we can disable average option so as not to average quad's shape. A face mode has also been added where the shape of the quads will depend on the shape of the active polygon. Even mode makes all polygons square. The most important feature is that we can now quadrify not only islands, but also selected parts of islands in selection mode. You can make a cut on quad geometry by selecting edge and pressing quadrify. But to do this, you need to rotate the model. Now you just need to select a polygon and the algorithm will automatically select the edge on the backside where the cut will be. The only limitation is that it works on an active polygon. We have also added special annotation for Quadrify, Match and Stitch, and Fit into Region operators, which can be enabled in Preferences. It provides technical information about how these algorithms work. A number of new select operators have been added in this update. When UV sync is off, it's unknown which edges are linked. Now we can solve this by clicking Select Linked, which works great in combination with Match and Stitch. Now in Select Borders operator you can not only select the borders of all islands, but also the borders of the selected island and the borders of the selected faces. Select Quad Islands allows you to select all Quad Islands, and you can quickly quadrify them. Select Splits helps to select edges that belong to the same mesh edge and splits islands by itself. It is useful for cylindrical meshes. One more operator is Select Edges by Conditioning. For example, I want to select all edges that have sharps but not seams. To do this, we need to select the first condition, sharps. In the second, we select end, not. And in the end, we need to select seams. Now we can add seams where they were missing. And last operators, select face edge loops, are used to pass information about selected faces and edges on UVs to geometry when UV sync is off. In 3D view context, you can do the opposite. We have a house where we need to set the required texture density on the balls. Knowing the sizes of texture elements, this is very easy to do. In trims, we need to select brick texture and create a trim according to the size of one brick. And in properties of trim, indicate the dimension of this brick in centimeters. After this, we can select all the polygons with brick texture. In the list we see brick trim, all we need is click set. Let's do the same for the roof part. In this way you can quickly set good texture density for architecture 3D models. To store values, we added UV world size presets. Don't forget to subscribe and thanks for watching.